Welcome friends, my name is Dev Impath, and today I'll be showing you everything you need to know about shadows in Eevee. I'll take you through what each setting does and what it means. Let's get started. We'll start with the default scene where we're just going to delete the cube. We're going to add a plane, scale it up a little bit, and then add a monkey on top of that. GZ, grab it on the Z axis and just drag it up a little bit. And now we essentially have our monkey. So I am going to rotate her a little bit so that she's towards the light. Here we've got our simple test scene. And basically we're going to enable viewport shading. We're going to make sure that Eevee is selected. We're going to roll on down to shadows. And let me show you what every setting does. This setting that's enabled by default, called soft shadows, if we switch it off, we'll kind of see the shadow become a little harsher. Now when I turn it on, you'll kind of see that it jiggles away. What's actually happening here is that Blender is taking the light, and then when we enable it or when we move it, it's kind of moving the light around a little bit. It's jiggling it. So you can kind of see if I jiggle it there. And then what it does is it saves that all of that shadow data. And basically you get a softer shadow. This high bit depth, you really only notice relatively close and on really detailed shadows. Here I'll enable it and we'll kind of see the mouth of the monkey get a little bit better. It's difficult to see exactly, but basically it's more accurate. Do you want more accurate shadows? Enable high bit depth. But for most cases, you can leave it off unless, as I say, you have complex shadows. Cube size is basically the quality of the shadow. In a more technical term, it is the cube shadow projection map size. 64 pixels, you'll see that it's very rough and rough around the edges. And basically, as you just improve this up the setting, it just gets better and better. Obviously, this does take more RAM. Every single setting up takes much more RAM than the previous setting. So this is something to be a bit careful with if you have a very large scene with lots of shadows. The cascade size is exactly like the cube map size, except it only affects sun lamps. You can even see this when you hover over it. It says size of sunlight shadow map. Basically changing this makes no difference on ours because we don't have a sun. But if we change this to sun, 50, but you can basically see that the shadow is a lot nicer there. We're just gonna go back and put our light back to a point, just so that we back to where we were. Light threshold, this basically clips or cuts out any light that doesn't qualify from the overall lighting in the scene. Now, the easiest way to do this is in your own scene, kind of drag it up and down. A lot of the times it's not really necessary, but you can kind of see there as I drag it up, you see how it is sort of cutting light out, because obviously remember our light is here, so at this point on the plane is the brightest, as we can see from there. And as you slowly remove this light threshold, you're removing where the shadows can land essentially. So you can do this awfully close, but for most instances the default I think is 0.01 is just fine. And that's everything that you need to know about shadows in Eevee. I hope you have a great day further.